The title of our presentation, The Anisotropy of Light Propagation in Biological Tissue. This work have been done in the laboratory of materials for photovoltaics and photonics in Institute of Applied Physics of Moldova. This is the content of presentation and begin from the motivation of this work. And optical microscopy is the main tool to investigate observation of biological tissues. And about 20 years ago, the new alternative to the light field optical microscopy, the digital holographic microscopy was appeared. And they have some advantages in comparison with conventional microscopy. Among these advantages is numerical refocusing, which allow us to recover the 3D information about the biological tissue, then lensless imaging, and so reduce the aberration due to optical components. Then we can extract the physical parameters like index of refraction, transmission, absorption, reflection, and etc. from the 3D image of tissue. Then compensation of wave aberrations and chromatic aberrations through numerical or numerical means, or the recording the additional reference phase images. And we can use the different software to acquire and to extract information from to processing of the image. And we, in our investigation, we have used the LabVIEW and MATLAB software for the acquiring and processing the image. And of course, the disadvantages are, and main of this is reduced image quality due to the laser beam speckle noise and the sensitivity to disturbing environmental conditions. And to overcome of these disadvantages, at first I have said that most biological samples is a transparent for the visual region samples. And so the interesting, the face information about these samples, because face information contains information about refractive index and thickness and refractive index. And so we can analyze the structure of the samples under investigation. And the difference in the phase information, as you see, contains the information with the difference of the refractive index of the materials. And difference of refractive index say us about the components of the object and the structure of object under investigation. And once more, the light which we illuminate has some characteristics, first of them amplitude, phase, and polarization. And amplitude is not interesting to investigate the biological samples because they didn't absorb the light in the, from the region, region. Then we investigate only the phase. But the polarization is one of the main characteristics, may add the any information about the samples. And so in we propose the use the polarization of the light which illuminates the sample under investigation. And polarization represents the direction of oscillating electrical field of light. The polarization may be in different, may lie in different surface. For example, maybe linear, linear polarization in vertical and horizontal surface, and maybe circular polarization. And during the passing the light through the samples, this polarization may be changed, and so we can analyze the structure with changes the direction of polarization. And one of the characteristic which we can extract, this is anisotropy, optical anisotropy of samples. which influence or reflect the local order of the structures. This is maybe the collective rotation of atomic bonding, the overall alignment of molecular axis within the object, and etc. And the characteristic of this anisotropy is the Birif regions. And the Birif regions give the materials two different refractive indices along two characteristic directions of the during intrinsic the materials. And this is a parallel, a perpendicular direction, which influence on the light passing through the sample. And from this, we can see that difference in the phase distribution, the light consists of or determined by the difference in the refractive index of the materials. And this refractive index in turn is determined by the difference between these two refractive index inside of these two directions, parallel and perpendicular direction of the materials. And this is our digital holographic microscope. This is a phase shifting microscope, which is a Mach-Zehnder cam in object wave we introduced in the sample. And the microscope objective in the both arms of this microscope we introduced to magnify it and to can change the magnification in the suitable for the object under investigation. And the set of half wave plates can control the polarization which we have in the reference and in the object beam separately. And then we have used the liquid crystal variable retarder to do phase shifting in this microscope only by the delivering of the electrical signal. So without any moving mechanical part, and so this higher the stable of the this scheme at first, and then the accuracy of the phase shift which we put on the reference beam. And this the scheme of our microscope, and I have said that the all of the components were mounted on the cage system, and this rigid our microscope at first, and then the same, they reduce the vibration and the higher the accuracy of images which we obtain. And this application of our microscope at first, the study of the cancel and the cancel blood, hemoplast, the cancel cell of hemoplast. And at first we examine the, observe our sample under white light microscope to do the any scheme of the sample and then to adjust the magnification which can in which we can see the any features of this of these samples. You can see on the left image we can see any features of the sample, and on the light for more magnification we can, and then at this magnification in this example, this is a 60 magnification, we obtain the unwrapped phase map and the vertical polarization, then obtain on the horizontal polarization, and after that we do the difference between these two polarization, and this difference reflects the difference in the refractive index in the vertical and horizontal polarization, which we access the anisotropy in these materials. And from this, we can see that only dark cells of this material have the anisotropy, not all the cells of these materials. This is a difference between these cells which we can see from this investigation. And then we applied for the pollen cells our microscope, and the same as at the 8 magnification and 20 magnification, and we can see that only 20 magnification is enough to see the any peculiarities of these materials. And the same unwrapped phase map and vertical polarization, then at horizontal polarization, and this is 2D and 3D presentation of this. From this, we do the difference between these two polarization, and from this difference, we see that not all the materials of this sample has the any anisotropy. Only the membranes between the cells has the anisotropy. And then the head tissue. The head tissue, this is the muscle of head tissue. The we can study it at enough the 8 magnification, because this is a great great difference. This is a filament, as you see. And so from this, we obtain different phase map, but at different magnification. At first at the 8 magnification, and then in the 19 magnification. And we can see that all anisotropy is a very less in this question, but from the 19 magnification, we can realize the which structure we can we have seen on these samples. And then conclusion of our work, we presented the polarization sensitive phase shifting digital holographic microscope, and which acquires phase shifting holograms at two orthogonal vertical and horizontal polarizations. And this system was upgraded by liquid crystal variable retarder to perform phase shift in the reference beam. And the polarization dependent hologram are recorded by rotating the half wave plate. And this difference reflects the polarization dependent refractive index associated to the anisotropy of biological tissue under study. And the proposed method was applied to the cancer cells hemoplast, the pollen cells, and the heart tissue. And the results show that the polarization sensitivity exists in the cancer cells hemoplast tissue, and the pollen cells itself are not the anisotropic, but their membranes are birefringent. And any noticeable anisotropy in the heart tissue was not watched. And we consider that this result will provide reference for the future clinical diagnostics and pathological research. So thank you for